valuable as it used to be to bands. I think now there's a lot of people pushing YouTube,
yeah,
and getting some video content. It's great to listen to a song, but if you can see a visual as well, it maybe captivates your audience that little bit longer. So, whereas before, you go on MySpace, you might listen to 30 seconds, maybe a minute of a song. On YouTube, if you've got a video that you can watch, perhaps that person will stay and they'll watch right till the end, you know.
I think you've just got to find ways around of, you know, it's like, well, you've got to accept that a lot of people are going to download for free, whatever they can download for free,
yeah,
be it music, films, whatever. But you know, you've got to find a way of replacing that with something.
It's different in being seen by 100 mates at a local gig and being seen by potentially tens of thousands on an advertising campaign. Although a lot of people are probably going to say it's a sellout option or whatever. But those people can sit in the bedrooms at home and, you know, looking at stuff on the internet and not go out there and do,
yeah,
it. You know, these bands can struggle. And
we're all in bands. We've all been in bands since we're like 13. And you're in a band for a reason, because you want to be doing it for a living. I mean, we all love music, and if music could pay me to live, then brilliant.
Bottom line
but
is, I
you don't want to be sat in a pub in your 40s playing to nobody. You know, so there's sort of that contrast between, well, yeah, I would still play music whether we were making money from it or not, but to what scale you do it.
I think that YouTube is a new live scene. So, I mean, at the minute we're doing a music video for our track Unsure, and it's being creative with that kind of thing and then getting that out there. I mean, don't get me wrong, everyone loves playing live, we still do as well, but for a band that hasn't got the financial backing like some of the bigger bands have got, it's good to be creative, and people pick up on that and they respect that you're being creative, and if it's good enough, it'll get there, and that's what you've got to think to yourself.
So just here, this is where used to be a venue called the Duchess. I'm not exactly sure which building it was, but in one of these buildings, great bands like Oasis came and played here.
Nirvana
played here, Stereophonics played here. I think Oasis did an encore to Nobody. Well, this place is gone, but it was one of the iconic music venues of Leeds at one time.
This is Mission in Leeds. A lot of DJs play our music in here, Mission. Other place in Leeds as well, but we'll go down on the night out and have a good time.
Down the tree.
Definitely does.
We do really want to release an album, and we've sort of spent the last 10 years of our lives playing live and doing bits of recordings at a time. We're now at a point where we've got 9 recordings done, all in the same place, all sound like the same band. But it's been a while getting it done, but I think it'll be well worth it, that people can listen to something and go, yeah, that's definitely Remember the Hurricanes.